Bless you. Somebody in the crowd sneezing. This one popped up shallow right field. Coming in is Spears, but going back is Thompson. He will make the grab a good 15 feet into shallow right field. And again, that will keep Doty at third base with two down now. So the Tigers desperately not trying to waste a leadoff triple here in the bottom of the seventh.
Got to tip your hat to Burkett. Be able to keep that runner right where he is after a leadoff triple. That's one of the toughest things to do as a pitcher. Start off with a leadoff triple and not allow him to score.
Brody Dross now will stand in for Cade Veloso. Dross, the left-hander, batting for the 69th time this year. Curveball missing outside from Burkett. Dross with 16 hits on the year. 11 runs batted in, 10 walks, has struck out 22 times, has three doubles, and also four home runs in his limited at-bats. Look out, this one over the head and behind Drost, and Doty coming to the plate, the throw not in time. Doty coming in on the wild pitch, and that will make it 10-2 Tigers. So Burkett was trying to hold things steady there in the wild pitch. Equates in a run for LSU. One pitch can be all the difference.
Oh, yeah.
So now the base is empty and two outs. And a 2-0 count to Drost. Strike at the knees and it's 2-1.
Looks like that strike zone may be getting a little bigger here as we progress.
2-1 misses outside. Fastball at 89 makes it 3-1. Chris Crenshaw, the interim coach for the Jaguar baseball team. 3-1. Misses inside for ball four, so Drost earns a two-out walk. Had the entire season as an audition, I guess. Still checking, and it's interim coach Chris Crenshaw. Again, Southern having to scramble just before the season to have a head coach of their program. See what the future holds. That will bring Drew Bianco to the plate. First pitch, a called strike on the inside corner. Drew tonight 1-for-2, and his fourth home run of the year with a two-run bomb. The 0-1, high at the letters, evens it up. One ball, one strike. Fans, when the Tigers win, you win. Enter promo code LSU50 the day after a LSU baseball win, and you'll receive 50% off your online order at PapaJohns.com. Better ingredients, better pizza, Papa John's. Off speed from Burkett, misses outside, and it's 2-1. Drost at first base with two outs, and the fastball misses high and outside to make it 3-1 now to Bianco. Kerrick Jackson, previous coach at Southern, really had put a lot of momentum for the Jaguars program. Again, he was the head coach when Southern got the win in 2019 over LSU, just their third win in this series. 3-1 pitch and a foul ball. Tapper that goes foul left to the third base bag. Coach Jackson made the announcement that he would leave the program for a job with Major League Baseball last fall. So you gotta give credit to these players for the Jaguars. Again, probably felt like the world was collapsing when Coach Jackson decided to leave, but they have hung in there with Coach Crenshaw. This is a pitch high and inside. It'll be ball four. So back-to-back walks now will put runners first and second with the Tigers, leading 10-2 here in the bottom of the seventh inning. So the Bottom of the seventh extended. That'll give Jake Wyeth, who checked in for Milazzo, catching behind the plate, a chance to swing for the first time tonight. Wyeth just 30 at-bats. This will be the 30th at-bat. Hitting just 138 on the year. First delivery. Strike at the letters. I believe the strike zone has widened.
Yep.
It's 0-1.
But you know, maybe it should in a game like this.
Wyeth going to try to adjust to that new zone. The pitch. Rifled down the line, but foul. Second row of seats. Way down the line and right. And it's 0-2.
Tell you, someone that wanted no piece of that ball, that young lady sitting down that line, LSU bat girl, she was getting out of there in a hurry. Can't say I blame her.
I was going to say, as if we would have done anything different.
Maybe jumped over the wall to hide.
0-2 the count to Wyeth. Runners first and second with two outs. The pitch. Swing and a miss. Burkett able to get the strikeout. The Tigers add a run. Wild pitch brings in Kate Jody, who led off with a triple. One run on one hit. They leave two men on. Go to the top of the eighth inning. It's 10-2 Fighting Tigers. And this is Fighting Tiger Baseball.
This is LSU Fighting Tiger Baseball on the LSU Sports Radio Network.
Top of the eighth inning. Southern coming to the plate. They trail by 8 runs to LSU. It's 10-2. New pitcher on the mound for the Tigers. We will see Zachary Murray take over. He'll face off against Judah Wilbur. It'll be the 2, 3, and 4 hitters for the Jaguars, who again have 2 runs on just 2 hits. 1 error in the field. The Tigers, 10 runs on exactly 10 hits so far. Murray winds and the right-hander fires, and the first pitch misses high to Wilbur. It's 1-0.
Yeah, Zach Murray making his second outing of the year.
1-0 delivery, outside a bit high. It's now 2-0. delivery. Just about going around, but holding back is Wilbur. It'll be 3 balls, no strikes. Murray, another Georgia product out of the Buford area. 3-0 pitch. 4 straight balls. He'll give up the walk to Wilbur.
All kinds of defensive replacements this inning. Braden Doty's now in at first base. Mitchell Sanford is now in right field. Collier Cranford is at third base. Will Safford's in center. Zach Arnold's at short. And Wyeth stays behind the plate.
So Wilbur takes his lead off of first, brings Burgess to the plate. He had the double with two RBIs back in the fifth inning. And the first pitch from Murray is a called strike, and it's 0-1. So after four straight balls, he finds the strike zone. Maybe now he will center up, fly right. This one misses outside, and it's 1-1. 1-1, one strike. Runner at first, nobody out. Way outside with the second delivery, third delivery rather, and it's 2-1. Swing and a miss. Chase this one outside just off the plate, and it's 2-2.
I was glad to see a strike there. Murray can't afford to go any deeper in this at bat. This type of score, this game, this late in the game, strikes are a must. No negotiations.
2-2 the count. Burgess awaits the pitch. Lifted in the air. Shallow right field. Coming in will be Sanford, and he will be there. Drops to a knee and makes the play as Bianco was coming out from second base. Drew eventually curled off to the left and yielded to Sanford, who was determined to make that play, and he does for one out.
That's not a routine play when you don't play right field very often. It's a whole different angle from the bat, different read. Nice job there from Sanford charging in to get that one.
With one down, a runner at first, we'll see Taj Porter, the catcher. First delivery, fastball for a strike on the outside corner. It's 0-1. Murray working from the stretch, fires, swing and a miss, and it gets ahead. The third batter he faces, it's now 0-2. Tigers off to the plains this weekend, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. 6:30 first pitch against Auburn. The 0-2 tapper right of the mound. Coming off the mound is Murray. He will flip to second base, and there is Doty, already first base. And Doty is there. For out number two, runner will advance to second in Wilbur.
Saw Murray kind of go down to his knee there after he underhand flipped that ball. I don't think he thought he had enough on it.
He was pleading with the ball to
That's
get
right.
there.
Get there, ball. But we've all been there. That'll bring in a new pitcher.
We'll have a pitching change here for the Tigers, powered by Sunshine, your hometown John Deere dealer. In Louisiana, Zachary Murray comes in, records two outs in the top of the eighth. He'll hand the baseball over. We'll take a timeout, come back, tell you all about the new pitcher when we continue. LSU leading 10-2. This is Fighting Tiger Baseball.
play here. The home for Fighting Tiger Baseball. The LSU Sports Radio Network.
10-2, LSU leads Southern. New pitcher on the mound for the Tigers with two outs here in the top of the eighth inning. It'll be number 46, Alex Brady. Left-hander takes over. He'll face off against Tremaine Spears with a runner at second base and Judah Wilbur. First delivery from Brady. Swing and a miss. A little up in the zone. Swing and a miss makes it 0-1.
Alex Brady makes his 11th appearance. He's worked 7 1/3 innings, allowed 7 hits, 6 runs. They've all been earned. He has 4 walks and 8 strikeouts.
Wilbur aboard on a walk, advanced to second on a fielder's choice, and this one's going to be ripped to center field. Going back is Safford, and he's got it for out number 3. So the Jaguars done, no runs, no hits. They leave one man on base in scoring position. We go to the bottom of the eighth inning. Tigers leading 10-2. Back in a moment. This is Fighting Tiger Baseball.
Your Fighting Tigers play here. The home for Fighting Tiger Baseball. The LSU Sports Radio Network.
10-2, LSU leading Southern here on a Monday night. Braden Doty checked in at first base there at the top of the eighth inning. Going to bat for the first time to start things in the bottom of the eighth. EFCU Financial offering great rates on home loans, home equity lines of credit, auto loans, and much more. To apply, visit any location or EFCUfinancial.org. Burkett continues on the mound. The first pitch sent right back into the screen off the bat of Braden Doty, and it's 0-1. Burkett starting his second inning for the Jaguars, giving up 1 hit, 1 run. It was earned. 2 walks and a strikeout. The 0-1 off speed but upstairs. 1 ball, 1 strike. Here's the 1-1 pitch. Swing and a miss. Right down the middle. The fastball got by Braden. It's 1-2. At the left hander. 1-2 inside, gets away from the catcher Porter, and it's 2 balls, 2 strikes. And Doug, you realize the importance of Coach Maneri and Coach Crenshaw trying to get this game in, certainly for LSU. They wanted a midweek game, not risking a washout on Tuesday due to severe weather possibly in the area, which means they would turn around travel to Auburn on Wednesday, so no chance to make that game up. It was important to get some action on the diamond headed into a very important series this weekend. Here's a swing and a miss. Braden Doty down on strikes. Burkett with his second K in relief, and there's one gone in the bottom of the eighth inning.
I think it's huge to be able to get this game in. And you know, technology today allows you to see in the future, really, and be able to plan accordingly. And we've seen that happen several times this year where the grounds crew and the staff for this baseball team have been able to be proactive with bad weather.
Standing in, Mitchell Sanford. Sanford batting for the first time tonight. First pitch, a called strike. Sanford, a left-handed hitter. Here's the 0-1. Misses at the letters. One ball, one strike. 52nd at bat for Sanford on the year. He's got 15 hits. Scored 12 runs. Six runs batted in. Three walks, 16 strikeouts. There's a strike for Burkett to get ahead 1-2. Sanford with one home run on the year. Was almost scared earlier today to look into the future and the forecast for Auburn. The Tigers really been hampered by weather virtually every SEC weekend. 1-2, called strike three, just above the belt. Burkett, back-to-back K's here, records the second out of the inning. Three strikeouts for the Jaguar reliever on the night. And with two down, it's a Gavin Dugas. But right now, good news is the weather looks agreeable on the plains for Thursday, Friday, and Saturday.
Well, that's good.
So keep your fingers crossed.
Look at Matt Beck getting in that bat.
Oh, it's going to be
so
Matt Beck.
I'm so jealous right now. I hope he hits a dinger.
Matt Beck going to bat.
Get that foot down, big guy.
And Gavin Dugas.
Ooh.
On the first pitch, he swings high, a foul ball. Goes way down the line and right, but out of play. What a big swing there for Matt
Beck.
I like
it. That's why you can't get cheated here. You got to go big or go home.
Beck wearing number 8. Expected to be a team leader this season. Unfortunate arm issues. Unable to come out of the bullpen, which has really hampered LSU. There's no doubt about it without number 1, his pitching and leadership. This one a called strike at the knees off speed from Burkett. It's 0-2. The fans don't like it.
I haven't pulled for a hitter this hard since Austin Bain dug in the first time.
Beck, the big right-handed hitter. Down in the count, 0-2. The pitch. Puts it on the numbers and drops it into right field. Little bat toss from Matt Beck. And he's 1-for-1 and a 2-out single.
Oh.
Hunter Keel gives him a big hug at first base. I see you, Matt Beck. Boy, look at Blake Money. He's some kind of fired up in front of the dugout.
Every pitcher in there is fired up.
Down 0-2. Took a big hack down the line in right foul. Took a strike two. And then belts one to right field.
That's bragging rights for all the pitchers.
Now let's see if he knows how to run bases. He'll take a lead off first. First pitch offered up to Cranford. Sent high in the air, foul territory, left side, and down in left field, A.J. Walter will make the grab for out number 3. But the story of the eighth is Matt Beck comes in to pinch hit. Picks up his first hit as a Tiger. LSU leads 10-2. Top of the ninth coming up. Beck gets an ovation on his way to the dugout.
As well he should.
This is Fighting Tiger Baseball.
Thank you.
This is LSU Fighting Tiger Baseball on the LSU Sports Radio Network.
Last chance for Southern. They're down 10-2. We head to the top of the ninth inning here at the box on a Monday night. And while the Tigers have plated 10 runs on 11 hits, that last hit from Matt Beck going to be the story of the night. Certainly, if this game holds out. Alex Brady back out on the bump. It'll be Xavier Moore at the plate. The first pitch, a called strike at the knees. And Coach Doug, you got to know this weekend in Auburn, somebody's going to be in that dugout, maybe down in the bullpen, saying, hey, coach, put me in. I can get you a hit.
Oh, there's no doubt.
This one misses outside from Brady, and it's one ball, one strike.
But it won't be Matt Beck. He wants to keep that average at 1,000.
Here's the 1-1. Missing outside from Brady, 2-1. Moore on the night. Struck out the last two times looking in the fourth and sixth inning. Again, the Jaguars only three hits tonight. Scored two runs in the top of the fifth inning. Pitch swung on, popped up near second base. Arnold calling for it, and Arnold will have it for out number one. One down and two to go. And Coach Palmieri out, wants to get one more pitcher into the game. He'll make the call to the bullpen. The pitching change powered by Sunshine, your hometown John Deere dealer in Louisiana. One down in the top of the ninth, and LSU leading 10-2. Back in a moment. This is Fighting Tiger Baseball.
LSU Fighting Tiger Baseball on the LSU Sports Radio Network.
Trent Vidmeyer comes in trying to find the final two outs here in the top of the ninth inning. LSU leading 10-2. Bubba Thompson at the plate. Thompson 1-for-3 on the night. First pitch for Vidmeyer rides in a little high with a fastball, and it's 1-0. Well, no surprise. We can expect later tonight Todd Peterson going to check in probably via social media to give a tip of the cap to Matt Beck. Here's a strike from Vidmeyer to make it 1-1. Another fastball offering to Thompson.
A little difference between Beck and Peterson,
though.
Beck actually was a hitter in high school. Hit 460 his senior year. I don't know that Todd Peterson had an at-bat in high school.
Well, he said he did. This one misses low. And it's 2-1 to Thompson. I think the quote was, I hit bombs.
I hit nukes.
Nukes, that's it. Here's the 2-1. Swing and a miss. Vidmeyer blows the fastball by Thompson, and it's 2-2. Two pitch, swing and a miss. Elevated the fastball that time. Down on strikes goes Thompson. Two down, one to go.
That is the seventh Tabasco's strikeout of the game for the Tigers. Tabasco is the official hot sauce of LSU Athletics.
Nice job picking up your partner.
Thank you, bud.
Isaiah Adams now comes up. Last chance for the Jaguars trying to extend this game. They're down to two outs in the top of the ninth. Pitch from Vittmeyer misses low and outside. It's 1-0. Delivery, strike on the outside corner to even it up 1-1. Tigers again on the road to take on Auburn. Thursday, 6:30 first pitch. Friday, 7 o'clock, Plainsman's Park. And then a change over the weekend. It'll be a 2 o'clock first pitch on Saturday. The 1-1 sent into the screen above the first base dugout. And Vittmeyer ahead in the count. One ball, two strikes.
Yeah, I think this is the biggest weekend of the year. Every weekend after that will be even bigger.
Two down, top of the ninth inning. LSU up 10-2. Vittmeyer ahead in the count. One ball, two strikes to Isaiah Adams. Right-handed hitter awaits. The pitch from Vittmeyer misses outside. That'll even the count 2-2. Coach Maneri telling us before the game, this is the biggest game of the season thus far. Check in with him on Thursday. Guarantee he will say it's the biggest game of the season thus far on Thursday night. Here's the 2-2 pitch.
Yep.
Oh, just missed the outside corner to fill the count 3-2 to Adams, who was willing to let that pitch go, put his fate in the hands of Alex Ziegler. So Vittmeyer with a payoff pitch upcoming. Two outs, top of the ninth. Tigers up 10-2. The pitch, swing and a miss again. Top shelf fastball from Vittmeyer, and that will do it. Tigers get the win here on Monday night by a final of 10-2 over the Jaguars. They beat Southern twice on the season and stay unbeaten against in-state schools here in 2021. With the victory, the Tigers move to 27-17. With the loss, the Jaguars fall to 13-23. Tigers win 10-2 over Southern. More coming your way when we return. This is Fighting Tiger Baseball.